Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. In the previous video, we have discussed using macOS 10 Snow Leopard in 2020. I basically installed it on a hard drive, on SSD, and I just tried to show you how it's actually possible to use it. Today, I'm going to extend this video because I actually installed like modern applications. I really actually tried to use it in 2020, and I just wanted to share my experience about it. So the first thing I wanted to note is the PowerPC app support. So for example, right now I'm running the Word 2004 for Mac, and it's working perfectly fine, and it's a PowerPC application. It's never was designed for Intel chips. So yeah, it works fine. The only thing that I didn't actually like about Word 2004 are those floating panels all around. It's like, nah. For me, it's kind of annoying. I like when everything is like in one place. I don't like it when it's fragmented like that. But still, you can use it for reading the documents and working with documents. Another thing I wanted to mention is that almost all productivity apps are available. For example, I work 09. I use it back in those days. For example, Numbers. This is like Excel for Mac, basically. and it still works fine. You can still work with it. Even the interface doesn't feel like dated, right? You can still work with your Excel spreadsheets right here. And as I said, the Aqua interface from the past is really, really cool. I just love it. All right, so the next thing I wanted to talk about is the developer options out there. For example, I have a video where I actually talk about Linux tools for Mac, which is, for example, Mac ports, Homebrew, and all those tools available for you for your convenience. For example, Mac ports is actually a way to install packages on your Mac. For example, if we type port search, let's say MC. Yeah, I know MC is my favorite application. Midnight Commander, And yeah, it shows all the packages available, like all those packages, and you can install those packages like that. Port, install, and then name of the package. I actually already installed the Midnight Commander, so if I type MC, here's how it goes. There are many packages available for Snow Leopard, so it's not a problem. You can use those. To be honest, it still feels kinda modern. Next thing, of course, the classic Mac interface. I already talked about that, but this is just so cool having this kind of interface. And the widgets, by the way, widgets, I think like weather widget doesn't work anymore for some reason. Obviously it was removed in Catalina, like widgets are not available anymore, but still, it's kind of cool. All those animations like that, it just like was so cool. Later, all those cool effects and abilities were replaced by something else. To be honest, I use Mac, but I don't use all those features nowadays because I don't like it. I don't need those virtual desktops I was able to get even with Snow Leopard, which is like just straight to the point, easy interface, expose and spaces right here. It was enough for me. I don't really need anything more than that. Next thing, of course, the Pro apps. For example, the Final Cut Pro. Here's how Final Cut Pro looks like, and you can still work export 1080p movies, as far as I remember, in this version. This is a Final Cut Pro 7, definitely a good version, and still works here, and of course you can use iMovie. This is totally fine for modern times. GarageBand, for example, you can use to write music and stuff like that, so it's cool.
Alright guys, I was telling so many good things about the Snow Leopard, but for some reason the QuickTime failed on me and I was not able to finish the screen grab. For some reason it just failed, so instead of screen grab, let's go with the good old, just like using the phone for recording the video method, kind of. What I wanted to tell you is that it's also really good for ripping the CDs. For example, I have iTunes right here and I use it to rip the CDs, like many CDs, different CDs here, and it's still great for that reason. You can still play lots of music and like have a huge library on this device. So yeah, it's perfectly fine for those purposes. Here's actually Winamp, and Winamp, guys, you know that I love Winamp, so you can still use Winamp right here. It works fine. So many options for having a great music library on this machine. This is great, and it also has the CD DVD drive right there. Totally great solution for ripping CDs. Next thing I wanted to tell is that YouTube still works, and in the previous video I actually tried to play YouTube, but it was failing for some reason, I don't know why. And today, instead of screen grab, let's actually open this specific app, which is called 10.5 Tube. As you can see, it just opens the mobile version of the YouTube. And if I type something like my channel, Nomadic Dmitry, and if we open any video, It plays those just fine. The only thing is that it doesn't play those on the full screen, which I mean is fine. I think it plays in the, like a medium quality, which is like 360 or something, but it's still, I mean, still possible to view and it's totally fine. I mean, again, so YouTube works, not a problem. But I mean, this application is kind of buggy, but you can find this in the internet, and yeah, it has some interesting bugs. And there are more browsers available. For example, the Stainless. You probably remember all those browsers when before Chrome there was like a huge variety of different browsers. But of course, if you open anything modern on those, like YouTube again, here's what you get, right? So this is expected. But let's see, let's open something different, like Fox News, I don't know. And yeah, so Google works, Fox News. So it works with some websites, it doesn't work with the others. As you can see, it loads this just fine, so it works. And of course, there's another browser which is called Rocket. This one, I don't know, but again, just kinda interesting. As you can see, the tabs are displayed like that. Something really different from nowadays, because right now all the browsers look like Chrome. Come on, it's just like a copy of Chrome those days. That's And of course, the Arctic Fox, the main browser that you're probably gonna be using. By the way, here's the GitHub page where you can download it. Yeah, I think I'm also gonna provide it down in the description below, so you guys go check it out. So Arctic Fox is a nice browser, but some websites don't work there. For example, Duolingo, as far as I know, this one doesn't work. This is a website for learning languages, and this one doesn't work. So just be aware of that. And not sure if it works in any other browser, like for example, in Stainless, does it work? This doesn't work here either. Safari, I was wondering. No, it doesn't work. It's actually funny, it suggests you to download Safari, but it's actually Safari. Yeah, guys, not all websites work. This is the problem, but you can just like try, experiment, try different browsers. Here it is. It's actually still possible to use Snow Leopard in 2020. It's totally a possible option for your old applications, your old games, and it's not a big deal. It works just fine. But yeah, just there are some caveats, and I'm probably gonna use it for example, like recording the audio. As you can see, I have this external sound card, which is Scarlett 2i4. I'm able to record audio from this one, so I can just like record music there, which is kind of cool. When I decide to shut down some application, let's say I'm gonna press shut down, and I mean it just shuts down in a few seconds. That's, I don't see this in a modern Mac anymore. That's my point. I feel like the Mac OS actually regressed in this recent years. Before, it was kind of like very optimized and stuff like that. So Snow Leopard was a good example. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Press the like button if you like this video. Thanks.